Today I will share with you 5 popular components from Bootstrap 5 that will make your life easier as a web developer and allow you to build nicer, responsive websites and in less time. Hey, my name is Jay from Coding with JayBird, and here on my channel I like to talk about coding tips and tricks that'll help build your confidence in coding. I'm excited to dive in and share with you these 5 Bootstrap components and how they help me build faster, nicer looking, responsive websites. I'm starting with the starter template that comes from Bootstrap 5's website, and I've added some loyalty-free images from Pixabay. Let's look at our first component. The first component that I'd like to look at are nav bars. Every website needs a nav bar, and Bootstrap makes it so easy to set one up. As I scroll through here, you can see there's so many different types of nav bars. Now, this is a good nav bar to choose because I see a mix of regular links and drop-down links. So I'm just going to copy this code. Let's add our nav bar next. Not bad, but it's a bit dull. We can change this to a darker nav very easily. All we have to do is change 2 of the classes in the main nav. We'll set it to navbar dark and background dark as well. And that's it. We have a nice looking nav. We have some drop down links. You can see pricing. When I first started this video, I told you that I'd be showing you how to build responsive websites. So let's try to reduce the screen size and see what happens. We get a nice hamburger menu. And look at that, our links look great. The last component that I'm going to talk about in this video is my absolute favorite. I use it in almost every website that I build. All right, let's move on to our second component now. So this is going to be a carousel. Let's go get our carousel from Bootstrap's website. Now there are many carousels to choose from. Some basic slides, some slides with some basic indicators. I like this one. It has some description and some details for each one. So let's copy this code. Now the slides don't come with any images, obviously, so we have to add some images in ourselves. All right, let's check out our carousel. I like it. That was really easy. All we had to do was copy a little snippet of code, add our images, and voila, we have a nice carousel. And if I shrink the screen size, it's responsive. Can't complain with that. If you're enjoying this video, consider giving this a thumbs up and subscribing to my channel for more coding tips and tricks. Leave a comment down below and let me know what you think, or if there's something new that you'd like to learn. Now, typically the content of my webpage is not full width, so I'm going to put everything in a div with a class of container. My next most popular component is an accordion. There are many accordions to choose from. We can have a basic accordion, which has a few items and you have to click on each item to expand them. We also have an accordion where an item can always stay open. I kind of like this one. So let's add this to our code. We can change the name of the accordion items. So maybe I can call this one just item 1. And then we can have item 2. And then lastly, let's say item 3. That's it. We have an accordion. That was really quick and easy. Once again, all we had to do was copy a little snippet of code, paste it into our HTML, change the text around a bit, and we have a nice looking accordion. And it's responsive. So let's test out the accordion. All I have to do is click on each one of these arrows to open and close the details for that accordion item. The fourth most popular component that I'd like to talk about is a modal. Now I use modals quite a bit, especially when I have forms that I'd like the user to fill out. There are so many modals to choose from. We have a basic one with some buttons inside of it. We have a static backdrop modal, a scrolling long content modal. There's just tons and tons to choose from. I'm going to pick the static backdrop one. So let's copy this and paste this into our markup. As you can see, it's not that many lines of code, and all the styling came with it, along with a button that's going to trigger the modal to open. So all we need to do is add some content to our modal body itself. So let's add a paragraph tag, maybe with some Lorem 100. And all we have to do to trigger the modal is click on this button. That's it, there's our modal. It's pretty nice, huh? All right, let's talk about my favorite component next. I love using Bootstrap 5's cards. They are so easy to use and make a site look so nice. You can easily put them in a 12-column grid system and make them responsive. I just love them. I can't say enough good things about them. Let's check them out. Just like with all of Bootstrap's components, there are many variations. There are so many different types and orientations of cards. Here's a very basic card with some text, a title, and a button. And then further down, you'll see we have other cards that have no buttons, just images. You can even have ones with list items and footers at the bottom. Let's get this one that's called Kitchen Sink. So again, all I have to do is copy the source code and paste it into my markup. Just like the carousel, it doesn't come with any images. So all we have to do is add the image that we'd like to put in there. It comes with this basic width of 18 rem, which I don't want. You can easily put cards inside a 12-column grid structure, and you can make them 3 columns wide, 4, 5, 6, as wide or as narrow as you'd like them to be. And I have another video on that, which I will be showing you at the very end of this video today. I like it. Can you see why it's my favorite component? I have so many purposes for this and so many different websites. I'm sure you're gonna love it too. Not all cards look the same. There are vertical cards, there are even horizontal cards. So let's put this within a div of row and then have 2 separate columns, and I'll show you what a horizontal card looks like next. I'm just gonna move this first card into the call-4 class. I'll create a call-8 class in which I'm going to place a horizontal card. So let's go get that. Okay, and this is what a horizontal card looks like. Pretty straightforward. So let's grab this code again. We're going to add it to our markup and we'll change the source image. Now, once again, it comes with a preset width. So let's delete that width and let's check it out. That was way too easy. Tell me you don't like this. Like I said, this is my favorite component. I use it across almost all of my websites, and I hope you're going to see some value in that and use it as well. Hey, if you enjoyed this video, you'll probably really enjoy this video as well. Click on the screen right now to learn more about how to code using Bootstrap 5 in 2023. I hope you enjoyed this video. See you guys in the next one.